Hi everyone. So now we're going to be talking about the properties of dictionaries. So the first property of dictionaries is that a dictionary maps keys to values. In this example, we make a dictionary where the key is Fred and the value is 38. What we essentially say is that in this dictionary, make the key Fred map to the value 38. And so when we print out, when we look up what does Fred give us in this dictionary, we get 38. Now if we printed out the actual dictionary, we would see that it's a dictionary where the key Fred maps to the value 38, just as we expected. Dictionaries are a lot like the dictionaries you would see with the standard English language, like Webster's, where basically you have words in your dictionary which map to definitions. In this case, we have keys mapping to values. Now, a key property of dictionaries is that the keys that you put into a dictionary are actually stored inside a set. This will lead to a lot of properties which only make sense if you know that the keys are a set. So the first property, like what we saw with sets last week, is that keys are unordered. Now if we look at this example, we put 2, 4, and 8 as keys into our dictionary. Now, it actually prints out in order as 2, 4, 8. However, we can't always predict this. So let's say I said D of dog maps to 42, and D of 3 maps to 2000. If I print this out, then notice how 3 was actually put in the middle, and dog was put at the end. Now, because you know how sets works, this shouldn't be no surprise to you. The keys go into specific buckets, and the order at which they're printed out is unpredictable. Next, similar to sets, the keys in a dictionary must be unique. So in this example, we put 2 into our dictionary 3 times. However, notice when we print it out, there is only a single 2. Now, notice how it said that 2 maps to 400. This is because when we put the first 2 in, it says, okay, it has the value 100. Then we say, override that 100 with a 200, and then finally override that with a 400. So, because the keys in that dictionary are sets, there can only be one value, and Python will take the value which you last gave it. And finally, another thing which should be no surprise is that the keys inside of a dictionary must be immutable values. Now notice here we make a list A. Remember, lists are mutable. We try to make A key mapping to 42. However, we get a crash because unhashable type lists. Now as we discussed last week, remember that when you try to put a mutable value into a set, it will hash it and try to find what bucket it goes into. However, when you try to hash a mutable value in Python, it crashes because it says that it's an unhashable type. And so, when we try to put this list as a key, it doesn't work. Now, the keys in a dictionary are sets. However, the values can be whatever you want. And so the values that we put inside of a dictionary have no restrictions on them. They can be mutable, and they can be immutable. In this example, we make the list A, and we say that Fred maps to this list 1, 2. We print it out, and it works just fine. We even destructively modify the list A, and we say, what does Fred map to? And Fred maps to the list 1, 2, 3, as we destructively modified. But once again, we try to make the list A a key, and it crashes. Finally, dictionaries are extremely efficient. Now, this goes back to the whole concept that the keys are actually a set. Imagine if you wanted to look up a value in a dictionary. All you would have to do is take the key, find it in the set, and then get the value right there. The same reasons that sets are very fast are the reasons that dictionaries are fast as well. When we want to look something up, we go straight to that bucket and get the value there. When we look on further in the course, we'll see that this property of dictionaries allows us to make our code much more efficient, and so we can solve some problems a lot easier than if we wanted to use a list per se. And those are the properties of dictionaries.